to safely change two-factor authentication. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Question I got recently. I'd love to hear your feedback about how to correctly move to a different 2FA app on a mobile device. I've read that removing two-factor authentication accounts from an authenticator app can cause issues, potentially locking you out of your account. If I wanted to move my 2FA codes and accounts to a different authenticator app, what is the recommended way to do this? So, yeah, safety, or more specifically, as you say, not getting locked out of your account, is a very common concern when it comes to switching your two-factor authentication app or technique. Sometimes you can move an app-based 2FA from one app to another, but, well, to begin with, that's not very common. And B, not everybody uses this type of two-factor app. When using SNS or other forms of two-factor authentication, there's no secret key or anything really to share or move, even if you could. The good news is that the approach that I'm going to recommend is conceptually super simple, and it works with every form of two-factor authentication. You just need a little preparation. Here's the approach I recommend. Turn two-factor authentication off on the account. Or, if you have more than one form of two-factor authentication enabled, turn off the specific technique you're trying to move. Then, turn two-factor authentication back on, this time using the app, device, or the technique you want to move to. That's as simple as it gets. But before you run off and do that, there's some important preparation to do so that nothing trips you up along the way. We want to do this safely, after all. Now, I have to point out, you must be signed in. I can't stress this one enough. So many people want to change their two-factor authentication method specifically because they can't sign in. They've lost the old one or something's not working for some reason. That is not how this works. Your ability to sign in proves that you've got the right to make the change. If you can't sign in, well, then for all the service knows, you're just some random hacker trying to break in. Yes, you know and I know that you're not, but the service has no way to confirm it unless you're able to sign in. If you're having trouble signing in, particularly due to your existing two-factor not working, you'll need to use the account recovery techniques offered by whatever service you're using. Once you're signed in, then you can and should set up your new two-factor mechanism. Now, this part's going to seem a little counterintuitive, but having successfully signed in may not be enough, at least to remove an existing two-factor authentication. Some services are going to ask for additional confirmation that you are who you say you are. Similarly, if you're trying to make this change while traveling, the service may also think that, yeah, that's kind of suspicious, and they'll throw up some additional challenges. So, my recommendation. 1, do this while you're at home. 2, use a computer you've signed into recently, maybe even one where you've already said, remember me, or its equivalent. 3, make sure you've got access to all of the account recovery methods associated with that account. That means access to all the phone numbers and all the email addresses that might be used. In addition, if you have specific recovery codes associated with the existing two-factor authentication technique, make sure you have those within reach. And if you've got another device that's currently signed into that same account, have that nearby in case that's where a notification gets sent. When you remove the existing two-factor, either of two things will generally be required. You'll be asked to provide a code shown by or sent to the existing two-factor authentication technique. Or, if you don't have that available, you'll be asked to use one of these other recovery techniques that you've previously set up with your account. If you can't confirm that you are who you say you are with one of those techniques, you may not be able to remove the second factor. That, yeah, could put you at risk of being locked out of your account. Now, I want to show you very quickly with one example exactly what I'm talking about when I say remove two-factor and add it again. Here's one of my example Gmail accounts. I'm signed in normally. I'm going to click on the icon in the upper right and click on Manage Your Google Account. That opens another tab. Over here on Security, we have the option to deal with our two-step verification, as it's called in Gmail. I will click on that. It's going to ask me to reconfirm who I am because we're about to do something sensitive. So we enter the password to prove we are who we say we are. Like I said, this account has two-factor authentication turned on, so it needs me to prove that I can get into the account with my existing two-factor code. Fortunately, I can do that. And only now can I deal with or make changes to the account's two-factor settings. I could turn off two-factor completely if I want to. In this case, since I've got multiple different two-factors, I could add another one before removing the existing one, or I could just go ahead and remove the existing one, leaving maybe the backup codes or something else. But the bottom line here, as you can see, is that, yeah, I had to confirm that I could use my existing two-factor in order to be able to go in and make changes to my two-factor. But this is where it would happen for a Gmail account. Now, I actually went through this process myself elsewhere recently. Proton introduced its own two-factor authentication application that works on both desktop and mobile, which made me very happy because I actually use Proton for a number of different things. The prior tool that I'd used, Authy, ended their desktop support some time ago, and that was kind of annoying. Now, I have moved all of my two-factor codes to 1Password. The convenience of having my two-factor codes in 1Password far outweighs the teeny tiny decrease in security. It just makes two-factor so much easier to deal with. Unfortunately, I face a chicken and egg problem. My 1Password account is itself protected by a two-factor authentication. But even if I put that code in 1Password, which I could, it's impossible to use because I'd need the code to open 1Password, but I'd need to have 1Password already open to get the code. So you get the idea. In the past, or at least up until now, I'd kept my Authy running on my phone, specifically holding that 1Password two-factor authentication code. However, I don't need that anymore. I wanted to move it to Proton. So, two-step process. I disabled two-factor authentication in 1Password and removed it entirely from Authy. And then I re-enabled two-factor authentication in 1Password, this time using the Proton authenticator. The move went smoothly, actually, and I can now access the codes from my desktop or my mobile device or wherever I happen to be signed into my Proton account. Above all, use two-factor authentication. Make sure to save all the account and two-factor recovery information created or set along the way so as to make any future changes, this or others, seamless. For updates, for comments, for links to related topics and more, visit askleo.com/183865. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.